Coming up on StampedeTV, are books only made for reading? We'll show you a way that you can eat your books.
And we'll show you why Milligan's campus recently grew with more students.
We'll also have a recap on one of Milligan's traditions, that big party.
And we'll sit down with a Milligan student and find about her transition to East Tennessee.
You won't want to miss these stories and so much more. StampedeTV starts right now. Welcome to the fifth episode of Stampede TV. I'm Caleb Perhne.
And I'm Rebeka Lane. The Stampede is always looking for your ideas. If you have any story ideas or suggestions, email us at mcstampede@my.milligan.edu or visit our website at milliganstampede.com.
Are you in need of a few more SFP credits to graduate or just need service hours? Then join Link for their service day this Saturday, April 18th at the Johnson City Animal Shelter. The day of service will take place from 11:30 a.m. to 3 p.m. If you would like more details or to reserve a spot, email link at milligan.edu.
Just a reminder that Awards Convo is coming up on Thursday, April 23rd. This convo is dedicated to you, the students, and serves to highlight the academic achievements throughout the year. Be sure to join us as we celebrate the accomplishments of the herd.
Milligan's theater students have always put on top-notch productions, including ones for kids. Stampede TV's Molly Gumber has more on this semester's Theater for Young Audiences production.
Welcome to the Gregory Center for the Liberal Arts, a place where young actors gather to perfect their craft and entertain. Today, however, something else is taking place: the growth of a beanstalk. The theater, home to the Milligan class of Theater for Young Adults, is directed under Richard Major, and they are currently working on their upcoming premiere of Jack and the Beanstalk. The TYA group will travel to local Tennessee schools to share with students the art of performance and a story the audience will never forget. The cast will be masked, utilizing the Commedia theater style.
Commedia is an Italian theater style that utilizes stock characters in various scenarios. Classically in Commedia, the lover characters, usually Flavio and Isabella, do not wear masks. And I'm not entirely sure why, but I think it's because they tend to be a center of a show, or at least a main part of the plot.
Another aspect of this production, truly setting it apart from the fairy tale, is the original score, produced by Elias Quintero.
Well, I've always written some worship music, but I've always wanted to do theater music. Some of my classmates helped Jeanette Hart, so she got together some YouTube clips, and this would be good, and this is West Side Story, this is Les Mis, and so kind of from what I got from that, I was able to go to a piano and say, okay, well, this kind of sounds like a love song, or this kind of sounds like some kind of Disney villain-ish song. So bit by bit and piece by piece, I kind of put these songs together and made them for my friends who are playing the parts and made sure that they were comfortable with them and kind of fit their character, too, as people, not just as the characters. So
the group is expecting high energy from the students and the audience, and overall, a great show.
So, they should. I mean, it's fun, right? It's fun. Theater's fun. The masks are fun, the people, they're awesome actors, so I think they should portray the music real well and hopefully get stuck in their head, you know, bother their teachers with the little riffs and stuff like that, so it should be fun.
And this is Molly Gumbert reporting for Stampede TV.
Looks like a great opportunity for them to perform for other schools.
Yeah, definitely. The Theater for Young Audiences show wasn't the only play. Milligan's theater students recently performed the play Harvey. Stampede's Colin Holly takes a behind-the-scenes look of the production.
It was that time of the year again, and it fell to the theater's technical director, Pamela Adolfi, to construct two scenes, a manor scene and a doctor's office scene.
The one thing that I enjoyed most about designing this set, which was also a challenge, and that was to design the set in which it flowed nicely, effectively, efficiently from the house scene to the sanatorium scene.
Pam also utilized the help of other members of her staff to complete the task of preparing the intricate components of the set.
The bookcases. I like books. So I like the bookcases and that they have this flourish.
Probably the stained glass. It was really enjoyable to work on. It was a new technique I hadn't used before. And being able to use like canvas or muslin instead of being able to use glass was really neat. It was very creative being able to like lay out the colors and the process of all that. It was probably my favorite contribution to the set.
This has been Colin Hawley reporting for Stampede TV.
The set was spectacular, didn't you think?
Yes, she did a very good job on that. We're going to take a quick break on Stampede TV. Coming up, we'll have a fun man on the street. And can books be edible? We'll find out next. Welcome back to Stampede TV. Are you looking for a job but your resume isn't quite up to date? Well, stop by the Center for Calling and Career Exploration on the lower level of the sub on Monday, April 20th from 1 to 5 p.m. to get professional advice. Walk-ins are welcome, but appointments can be made in 30-minute intervals. To reserve a spot, email mjpoff at my.milligan.edu.
Johnson City's annual Joy Prom will be held at Grace Fellowship Church on Friday, April 24th from 5 to 8 p.m. Joy Prom is Grace Fellowship's spring fling for those with special needs and their families. For more information and to register as a volunteer, visit gfcnow.com/joyprom.
The Juried Art Exhibition will return to the Derthick Art Gallery on Sunday, April 26th, with the reception taking place from 2 to 4 p.m. The Juried Art Exhibition features students' best works from the semester in photography, sculpture, art, graphic design, and more. The art exhibition will be on display from April 26th through May 1st. If you would like to submit a piece, you can enter a total of 3 pieces from this academic year. The deadline to enter is Friday, April 24th by noon. Your submissions must be submitted to the art gallery by this time, and photographs must be matted and ready to hang. Be sure to stop by and check out the wonderful works.
The 2015-2016 year will be Milligan's 150th, otherwise known as sesquicentennial. However, how many people actually know what that means? I had the chance to hit the streets on this edition of Man on the Street. Milligan's 150-year anniversary is next year, which means we celebrate our sesquicentennial. We ask a few students what that meant.
Sesquicentennial.
Sesquicentennial, I guess.
Sesquicentennial.
Oh my gosh. Sesquicentennial.
Centennial?
Oh, sesquicentennial. Yeah.
Sesquicentennial?
Oh.
Sesquicentennial.
Sesquicentennial. I can't even say it.
All right, do y'all know what that means?
No idea.
No.
I'm assuming it has something to do with every year or yearly something.
Jeez, I don't know. 150 years?
Next year we are celebrating our 150-year anniversary, and that is what this word means.
That is cool.
Very nice.
Glad I know.
Milligan will begin its sesquicentennial celebration fall of 2015. I'm Rebecca Lane for Stampede TV.
All right, so can you say sesquicentennial?
Sesquicentennial.
Very nice.
When we think of books, a lot of us think of nothing but countless sheets of paper. But what if we told you that books can be edible? We've been hinting at this throughout our show, and Stampede TV's Jackie Snyder has more.
Milligan College's fifth annual Edible Book Festival was full of great edible treats in which each of them had a book theme. Students were asked about their opinion of the festival.
I went to the Edible Book Fair, and there was some really awesome creative cakes and food. My favorite was probably the Madeline cake, and the funniest was definitely the O'Jello.
Students were able to vote for their favorite ones with the categories of punniest, creative, slash tastiest, and overall.
It was hard to decide which one was my favorite. You can obviously tell that the students worked hard for these cakes. So I don't know which one I would pick. They were all pretty good.
The winners for this event was for punniest was 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, creative slash tastiest was Around the World in 80 Days, and overall was Madeline. After all the judging, students were able to go and eat the amazing treats. Thank you for your time, and this is Jacqueline Snyder reporting for Stampede TV.
So Caleb, I know you were able to go to the Edible Book Festival. How was it?
They had some very good things, very tasty, except I wasn't too fond of leeks and jello.
Oh, yeah, that doesn't sound too good. We're going to take another quick break. Coming up on Stampede TV, Tiffany Florian will sit down with Praise Weru to find out her journey to Milligan. Welcome back to Stampede TV. I'm Tiffany Florian, and today we're having our student spotlight segment, and I'm with freshman Praise Weru. Hey Praise, how you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm doing great, thanks for asking. So where are you from?
I'm from Kenya, which is on the eastern part of Africa.
Wow, very cool, awesome. So Kenya to Johnson City, Tennessee, how did that happen?
Well, that's quite a long story, but the short version of it is my parents are native missionaries in Kenya, and they have had a friend who's been part of their missionary work in Kenya for a while now, and he actually heard about Milligan, and he's been a part of Milligan for a while now. So when I finished high school last year, he just asked me to check it out online. So I went online, loved what I saw, I was able to come for a tour last year in the spring, and I remember just whispering to my dad at the end of the tour, this is where I want to come. Which was quite weird because I didn't want to come to a Christian university. I had been to Christian school all my life and just wanted to do something different. But so far so good. I really like it here, and the community makes you feel at home. So I'm far away from home, but it's not as hard as I thought it would be. Yeah.
That's awesome. So how different would you say Kenya is from here in Tennessee?
Well, the first thing is the weather. We have pretty moderate weather. It's the same all through because the equator passes straight through Africa, straight through Kenya. And so I've had to deal a lot with just having cold weathers in the morning, and then it's warm in the afternoon. So that's been a great change. Food has been another, difference. The food is, it's okay. I just miss my mom cooking for me and me having to eat, with my family. So.
So what's kind of your traditional Kenyan family dish that you'd eat at home?
Let's see. There's lots of rice dishes cooked different ways. There's a dish called chapati, which is basically like a tortilla bread, but it's a little more sweeter than your usual, just flat tortilla, and with beans or lentils, and we have lots of vegetables too and fruit. So yeah, I think Kenyan food is the closest thing to Kenyan food would be Mexican food.
Okay.
So yeah.
That sounds good. Yeah. So do you have a favorite American dish coming here?
Well, I don't know. I wouldn't say I do.
Yeah.
I like everything so far. I'm just grateful to have food.
Basically,
at the end of the day, that's how I look at it. It's food, and as long as I'm eating it and it's okay and I don't get sick, then I'm good.
Yeah, that's awesome. Okay, so what would you say were there any big obstacles in getting here?
Yes. I was to be here in the fall, and I couldn't get here because the U.S. Embassy in Kenya had my passport for a very long time. Okay. So that's definitely a hurdle I had to jump over just to be at Milligan. But I'm grateful I got to come finally this January. Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. So you made it here to Tennessee, but your family is still in Kenya, mm-hmm. right? Okay. Mm-hmm. So how do you primarily keep in contact with them?
We Skype every mm-hmm. Sunday. My mom will call me whenever she's missing me. So usually I'm just, you know, waiting. If she calls me when I'm in class, I gotta go take it because the time difference, the States is 8 hours behind. So if she calls me whenever, I just have to, you know, get on my phone and talk to her because I know it's late there. It's really early here. So that's how I've been keeping in contact. I just thank God for technology because I cannot believe how people went to school far away from home like 20 years ago without Skype, without the internet. It's good. I'm just grateful.
That's awesome. Yeah. So what's your major here at Milligan now?
I'm a business major and a music minor.
Awesome. Yes. Very cool. Yes. So what's kind of your ultimate goal to do with that?
My dream job would be working for the United Nations, either working for UNICEF or whichever program they have in the United Nations that just deals with economic development and just development of developing country or third world countries in Africa and Asia. I want to be an economic consultant and just create employment and then mitigate poverty at the end of the day. Yeah.
That's awesome. That's a really great dream. Yeah. So thank you so much for talking with me. I really enjoyed it. And thank you so much, Praise.
Well, thanks for having me.
After the break, we'll be back with sports.
Can't find something to listen to on the radio? Well, check out 90.5 WUMC Milligan College Radio. With student-produced shows airing each night, there is something for everyone. The best mix of music, along with talk shows about everything Milligan. For a complete list of showtimes or to listen live, visit us online at milliganradio.com. We're your radio station, 90.5 WUMC.
Welcome to StampedeTV Sports. I'm Neil Johnson. Thank you for joining us for another exciting segment of StampedeTV. The baseball team has battled a slew of rain recently, but they had a chance on Tuesday to play a game at Milligan's Anglin Field.
Despite taking early leads in both games of Wednesday's non-conference doubleheader against Southern Wesleyan, the Buffaloes were unable to come out on top. Senior Tanner Strange made the start for the Buffaloes and pitched 5 innings against the Warriors. The rain was no match for Buffalo fans as they came prepared to cheer on their team in the rain. The Warriors came out swinging, putting runs on the board in the first inning. But the Buffaloes responded quickly with back-to-back RBI singles by Andrew Copas and Sam Tarleton. The Buffs' bats were not enough to stop the Warriors as they took control of the game, winning 6-4.
Yesterday, I was blessed to be able to start against Southern Wesleyan. It was very rainy. We didn't know if we was going to be able to get it in. But thankfully, the good Lord held off the rain. Unfortunately, we lost, but we got to face adversity and now bounce back and get ready for the conference tournament and learn from our mistakes. This weekend, we play St. Andrews Saturday, Sunday. It's senior week, so it'll be my last time and all the other seniors' last time playing at Anglin Field, so I hope you can come out and support us.
The first pitch will be thrown at 6 o'clock at Anglin Field. Come out and support the Buffaloes on their senior night.
It was great seeing the baseball team play, despite the loss. We hope that they will turn things around for the next game. The streaming of select sporting events wouldn't be possible without the efforts of Milligan's Stream Team, a class of dedicated students that stream various events around the campus. StampedeTV's Haley Cox has more on this stream team.
This week, I'm showing off the Milligan College Stream Team, who makes it all possible to view Milligan games online. When asked what is the Stream Team, coordinator Daniel Peacock says it best.
Well, Stream Team is essentially a group of students who get together and they go to all these sporting events. And what they do is they set up equipment and they live stream the sporting events like baseball games or basketball games so that parents of the players and other students who are off campus at the time can see the team play and like support their teammates and their kids.
Stream Team isn't just all work and no play. You still have the opportunity to still be a fan.
My favorite part of Stream Team is just getting to go see the Milligan athletes play, see them do their thing, and get to show everyone else out there in the great world of the internet.
Stream Team is dedicated not only to streaming the Buffaloes, but to supporting them as well.
Working with Stream Team is really great because you get to just hang out with friends and go to these events. And even though you're working, you're still a part of the crowd. You're an active member of supporting the Buffs.
This has been Haley Cox reporting for StampedeTV Sports.
Thanks, Haley. If you're interested in joining Stream Team, email cbswaney@milligan.edu for information. That does it for the segment of StampedeTV Sports. Join us next time for more information on Buff Sports.
Welcome back once again. Do you want to listen to some great jazz music, but you don't want to go too far from campus? Then head on over to Sub 7 on Thursday, April 23rd at 9 p.m. for the Jazz Combo's Spring Concert. The Combo will be performing a wide array of music, so come and enjoy the sounds of the Jazz Combo.
Keeping with the music theme, how about a didgeridoo concert? The well-known group Didge Revolution will be performing a concert, music, and more from the land down under on Friday, April 24th at 7:30 p.m. Their use of didgeridoos and other unique percussion instruments are sure to take you on a musical journey. Don't miss out.
It seems like it was just yesterday when many of us attended Connections Weekend as new students here at Milligan. I had the chance to attend this year's recent Connections Weekend and discovered how Connections helps new students in the transition to college and what role we can play in the process.
Milligan recently held one of its two annual Connections Weekends for incoming students. The weekend helps incoming students to become a part of the Milligan community.
So this Admitted Student Day, or what we just call Connections, is really a way to connect them with other valuable people so that they can begin to see themselves at campus being a student.
The weekend featured several information sessions that provided useful tips for around 76 incoming students who attended the event, such as how to do your laundry, why you should study, and where to find information about campus events. They were even able to ask questions of a student panel. Incoming students also met with their faculty and student mentors over dinner. The mentors are grouped with incoming students based upon their major, and we're able to help them feel more at home.
She's like wonderful. She's already like helped me out so much, and it's really nerve-wracking, and she's helped me like relax already because she's really down to earth.
The student mentors played an especially important role.
They're sort of like a surrogate brother or sister for a new incoming student.
They just let us know about, you know, brings fans to your dorm room and just help with college life in general.
At Connections, incoming students were also able to take care of other important things before entering college, such as their student ID, registering for classes, and campus tours. Friday night's events concluded with a Vespers worship service to help the students become more a part of the Milligan community. Overall, Connections helped put new students at ease.
I'm actually really excited. This trip has really helped me, like, calm down and like know what to expect.
I'm pretty excited about it, and just the whole, you know, they're really big on community and everything, so I'm looking forward to that. And then, you know, also you get to learn more about God, and so I mean that's just extra, that's topping on the cake.
Milligan plans to hold another Connections Weekend on June 12th and 13th. This is Caleb Perhne reporting for StampedeTV.
We're excited for all the new Milligan students.
Certainly. For more information on the June Connections, you can visit milligan.edu/connections.
Milligan's Campus Activities Boards hold several fun and exciting events throughout the semester. Last week, CAB scheduled their first game night. Stampede's Alyssa Bartlett has more.
On Saturday, March 28th, the Campus Community Coordinator for CAB, Brittany Helms, and Graduate Assistant Garrett McDonald hosted a game night in Sub 7 for students to attend.
CAB hopes to just kind of pull the community together and just have fun and fellowship and unity throughout campus.
This event included games such as Operation, Catchphrase, and Human Checkers, as well as plenty of snacks.
We make it our mission to have good, you know, constructive, wholesome events that everyone on campus can come out to.
Students of all grade levels participate in this event. The fairly small gathering grew and grew as the night went on.
Normally we would have had life-size Candyland, you know, messy Twister, some water balloon fight, things like that, but it was just too chilly outside.
Students had lots of fun talking and laughing with each other. Many of the students played most, if not all, of the games. A raffle was also held to win a prize.
The drawing is for a mug, some chocolate, popcorn, Raisinets, basically just kind of a movie night thing.
My favorite game today was the giant Jenga. It's really good just to come out and be with like people on campus and meet new people that come to certain events and stuff.
This has been Alyssa Bartlett reporting for StampedeTV.
I was actually at the event and they had some awesome orange soda floats.
That sounds really good.
Music stands as one of Milligan's most highlighted talents, especially with the a cappella groups Heritage and Herd Mentality. Recently, both groups had a chance to perform for New York Voices, a world-renowned vocal group. Stampede TV's Colton Finner has the booming story.
The internationally acclaimed jazz quartet, the New York Voices, recently put on a masterclass for Milligan's own Herd Mentality and Heritage a cappella ensembles. The event happened on Wednesday, April 8th, in the McLaughlin Street Theater in the Gregory Center. The New York Voices were formed in 1987 by way of a college alumni group. They went on to win a Grammy in 1996 for their work with the Count Basie Orchestra. They're known for their close-knit harmonies and ability to adapt to any musical genre, whether it be big band, smooth jazz, classical, or R&B. The masterclass began at 7 p.m. and ended around 9 p.m. Heritage and Herd Mentality performed and then received feedback from the four masters. The event was free to the public and saw many students come out and support their friends in the two ensembles. This is Colton Finner reporting for Stampede TV.
We were really lucky to have New York Voices come.
Yes, it's great that they traveled all the way down for that.
Yeah. We're going to take one last break. Coming up next, we'll have a recap on a senior photo show and look at Milligan's That Big Party. Stay tuned.
Introducing a breakthrough in time management technology. A whole new day of the week. It's called Someday. Ingenious. Perhaps someday you are going to go skydiving. Enter a hot dog eating contest. Maybe ride a mechanical bull. Now it's on the calendar. You may want to retire someday. Ready for that? You'll really want this, a My Social Security account at socialsecurity.gov. You can estimate your future benefits, plan for your retirement, and how to save for it. If you already receive benefits, you can manage them online. Millions of people already have a My Social Security account. In fact, someone opens one about every 6 seconds. Get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
Thank you for tuning in to Stampede TV. The last week of classes is full of events by the Performing, Visual, and Communicative Arts area. First, on Monday, April 27th, the Milligan Jazz Ensemble will hold their annual spring concert in Seeker Chapel. The ensemble will be joined with special guest Doug Henry on tenor saxophone. Be sure to stop by and watch the always phenomenal jazz ensemble.
Continuing on Tuesday, April 28th and Wednesday, April 29th, the annual Festival of One Acts will take place in the Gregory Center starting at 6 o'clock p.m. both nights. The Festival of One Acts plays is a long-standing yearly tradition in which students direct short plays that they either wrote or found. Come out and see the talents of all the actors and directors.
And finally, on Thursday, April 30th, Buffalo Tales will be held in the Gregory Center starting at 6 p.m. Buffalo Tales features student stories as a part of the final exam for Milligan's storytelling class. The stories will be a combination of personal stories to common stories that you have heard throughout your life. So if you like a good story, you'll definitely want to attend this event.
Senior photography major Elena Sutherland's senior art show kicked off on Sunday, April 12th. Carissa Lamiro was there and has more on the event.
The Derthick Art Gallery was buzzing with visitors Sunday afternoon, April 12th.
Photography major Elena Sutherland held her senior photo exhibition entitled Compass, displaying her work from places across the country as well as close to home.
I got to do a lot of traveling through multiple school activities and through family vacations, and so I knew that I had a senior show, and so I had been trying to figure out what I was going to do for that, and it just seemed really fitting to do it for multiple travels that I've been doing.
Although primarily composed of black and white images, Sutherland's show also contained others of her work, including watercolor and oil paintings.
It's been a very large transformation, coming in not knowing anything about film besides that, like, my mom had used film growing up. I have a very deep appreciation for it now. It's definitely deepened my love for photography. I think it's important to me because it's allows you to capture something that you're very passionate about, whether that not even be photography, whether that just be the image that you capture of whatever subject it is. And I think it allows you to relive memories when you go back and look at those. You can, everything just comes flooding back. And I think that's probably the biggest part of it for me. I hope that they take away that there is beauty in different places all over the country and all over the world. But I think they also realize that it's not just always the grass is greener on the other side, that it's beautiful where you are, where your home is.
If you missed Elena's show, senior photography major Will Major will be hosting his show At War with the Ordinary on Sunday, April 19th.
I have taken a series of photographs that basically capture the people and places that I hold dear to my heart and that are considered ordinary everyday images, but are documenting the reality of who these individuals are and where how these places have shaped my life.
This has been Carissa Lamero reporting for Stampede TV.
Looks like Elena had a great show.
Yeah, she did. And you'll want to be sure to check out Will Major's show, At War with Ordinary, April 19th in the Derthick Art Gallery.
And last but certainly not least, another one of Milligan's traditions was in full swing recently. The annual Spring Fling, that big party, was held at Johnson City's Doubletree Hotel. Stampede TV's Amanda Florian has the story.
Hi, I'm Amanda Florian with Stampede TV. We are here on the red carpet as that big party is happening. Tonight's theme is Hollywood. Let's go see what students are up to. So tell me about your look today.
Well, I want to go for a little like classier look with the old Hollywood, so I decided to get the gloves. And I have obviously costume jewelry on, and I just took an old dress that I found that I kind of felt had that vibe. And of course, the hair and the makeup is very much old Hollywood and glamour.
Definitely. Well, I am loving it, and I love the sequin designs and the gloves you got going on. So what's one thing you're looking forward to tonight?
Oh gosh, just having fun with people that I probably won't be able to see, like everyone in one group, and it's really sad, but I'm just trying to enjoy the moment and live in this moment.
Hi, can I ask you a couple questions? Okay, what's your name?
My name's Kanan.
Kanan! Okay, so I'm here with Kanan Force, and can you tell me a little bit about your look today, Kanan?
It's just a little something I put together. I didn't know what to wear for this thing, so just picked a color that worked best, and I went for it.
Well, that color definitely works for you today. You're looking that magenta purple.
I'm out here sporting the bow tie. You know, it's a little old school frat style, but it's all about the accessories, you know. It's how we do it.
How does it feel to get all dolled up for an event like this?
It's very fun. I have to be formal every day, so it's not that much different, but I mean, this is definitely not my normal kindergarten outfit. So it's more exciting.
Definitely not your normal kindergarten outfit.
Just trying to figure out what old Hollywood looked like, and this is what I assumed, so.
Awesome, well, I'm loving the bow tie today. And what's something you're looking forward to for tonight?
Just a good time with my friends. You know, it's always a good time to be here and hang out with them and see everyone dressed up and stuff, so. Yeah.
Okay, so I love your look. Can you tell me a little bit more about it?
Well, it's actually my mom's dress, and it was her dress when she was my age, so I brought it back tonight.
That's awesome. Okay, what is something you were looking forward to out there?
Well, I'm just excited to have fun with friends and, you know, show off my dance moves.
All right, awesome. Well, go show us your dance moves. I'm here with Abigail Williamson as she is styling in a beautiful black and white composition.
This is a dress from high school. It was in my closet and it didn't cost money, so definitely worth another wear. I love it because it's black and white, it's simple, and I just feel like it's accentuating, so I like it.
I'm here with Matt Owens, and he's going to tell me a little bit about his classy bow tie look for the night. Hi, Matt. Tell me, what kind of look were you going for tonight?
I thought I wanted to keep it simple, you know, went out and found a bow tie that was awesome, and I think it's pretty classy. I just like the look of it. I think it fits the mustache well. It's a good combination, you know.
It really does. I'm loving the classic mustache we have going on with the bow ties and the stripes. Rocking the Ralph Lauren as well.
Yes, this dress is given to me by my boyfriend, and I just love it. It's my every party dress. I thought it really went with the Hollywood theme, too.
So what's one thing you're looking forward to?
Definitely the photo booth with my friends.
I had the chance to catch up with some students, take a few selfies, and hit the dance floor.
This year's event was hosted at the Doubletree in Johnson City, Tennessee, and the DJ brought the house down with some crowd-pleasing hits. Some of the featured artists were Walk the Moon, Taylor Swift, Bruno Mars, Flo Rida, and more.
It was an evening full of photos, fun, and dancing. Thank you so much for joining us on StampedeTV. I'm Amanda Florian. Good night.
Everybody looked great at that big party.
Yes, it looked like a great way to celebrate the end of the semester.
Yeah, definitely. And that's all we have for this edition of StampedeTV. Thanks for watching, and don't forget you can always email us with your story ideas and ways to improve the show at mcstampede@my.milligan.edu.
And you can also connect with us on Facebook and Twitter. Just use the hashtag #HeardThat to connect with us on Twitter. And be sure to like us on Facebook by going to facebook.com/Milligan College Stampede. So for now, I'm Caleb Perhne.
And I'm Rebecca Lane. Until next time, be sure to check out our website, milliganstampede.com, for the latest news information, and pick up a copy of our print version located at stands throughout the campus. Remember to always be a buff and have a great day on the beautiful campus of Milligan College.